Hi guys, welcome to Tremadog here in North Wales, and we're on a very exciting adventure. I've just shown you the square that we're in at the moment, and I've been staying here for a couple of weeks, just having a bit of a getaway, and I found out a location that was here that does have a cinematic link, and why not go and check it out? So, allow me to navigate myself down these treacherous Welsh steps. I'm going to just take a little walk down the square, and we're going to go to this location. Like I say, I only discovered this 2 days ago, and I stopped outside it to have a little gander, and it's really cool. Who would have known that in the middle of this really quaint, sleepy village in North Wales, that one of the most famous people of the 20th century, his story began right here. So, let's go and have a look. So we've moved just a little bit further down the road, and I can reveal, although I'm sure you already know because of the title of this video, the place where we're going to is the original home, the birthplace of Thomas Edward Lawrence. Who is that? Well, he's better known as Lawrence of Arabia, one of the first major celebrities of screen and war stories of the 20th century. One of the most famous people of that generation. It was argued that he was the most famous person in the world from the 1920s to the mid-1930s until he passed away. And this is his house, just here. If we just turn and have a quick look. I'm sure most of you are familiar with the 1960s film, which was directed by David Lean, a fantastic director. He also did things like Brief Encounter, Dr. Zhivago, hands down worth checking out his filmography. Ryan's Daughter as well, so many classics. Also stars Peter O'Toole as Lawrence of Arabia, Omar Sharif and Alec Guinness, as well as a whole host of others. But the real life Lawrence of Arabia, who was named Thomas Edward Lawrence, was born in this home. Thomas Chapman was the name of his father, and he was an Anglo-Irishman. He was living over in Ireland with his wife Edith, and they had a couple of daughters when he had a child in secret with the governess of his daughters. The governess was named Sarah, and then he fled his home in Ireland and came over to Britain, and this was the house they moved into in Tremadog. They had five children in total, and because it was essentially an illegal marriage, he was still married to Edith back in Ireland at the time. He came up with a fake name, which was Lawrence. So Thomas Edward Lawrence, who we know as Lawrence of Arabia, it's a fictitious name, so his whole life from childhood was clouded in secrecy. When he was aged around 10, he found out that his parents weren't actually married, and that him and his four brothers at this point were illegitimate children. This brought great shame on him. He always felt like an outsider growing up in his childhood, so he would retreat into the woods and the wilderness, taking books with him. He was a big fan of Arthurian legend, and he would read these stories about the great knights of old and medieval tales. And obviously, you can see the landscape where we are. A lot of the places around here would have been perfect retreats for him to go and read these tales. So he lived in this home from birth, from 1888 in the August of that year, through until it's argued around about 1894. So he was about 6 years old when he left. He then moved with the family up to Kirkcudbright in Scotland, as well as down to Jersey, Southampton, until he eventually settled around about 1896 in Oxford, which is where he stayed and went on to university.
But why exactly was he such an important and famous figure in the early 20th century? Well, he was in the British Army during World War I, and he was stationed in the Middle East, where there had been a series of warring tribes that had been oppressed for centuries. But he was able to unite them and get them fighting under one banner against the Ottoman Empire, which was regarded as being a major turning point for the Allies in the war. Some of his exploits were also caught on film by early cinematographers, and then when these were shown in parts of Europe and across North America in the newsreels, he reached unparalleled levels of fame. He was viewed as being a Robin Hood of the modern day. The plaque here is written in Welsh at the top and then English below, and it reads, paying tribute to a Welsh hero. This plaque was unveiled by Simon Weston OBE on the 19th of May 2015, on the 80th anniversary of the death of Lawrence of Arabia. T.E. Lawrence was born here in Tremadog on the 16th of August 1888.
So the home was called Gorthsivar, and apologies straight away because I don't speak Welsh. That is the best I can do. I tried, but it's a language that I found particularly difficult to try and speak any of. Today, however, it's known as Snowdon Lodge. So Gorthsivar was the Welsh name, which translates to resting place. But Snowdon Lodge, as it is today, is an accommodation that fits up to 35 people. So if you are in the area of Tremadog, Portmadog, Crickieth, around those sort of towns and villages in and about here, you can go and stay in the former residence of Lawrence of Arabia, which is a fantastic piece of history. I would love to go inside, but obviously things that are going on with COVID and lockdown, I'm unable to get inside at the moment. But next time I am here, I will definitely love to go inside. They have photographs, sculptings, and all sorts of different artifacts in there which are Lawrence of Arabia related. I really wish I could go inside and have a look. Maybe next time. Have you been? Let me know. Send us your videos or your pictures if you've been and stayed in this wonderful property. If not, are you interested to going to see it? Let me know. I would also recommend watching the fantastic Lawrence of Arabia film if you haven't seen it before. It's Steven Spielberg's favourite film of all time, if that should entice you. Not only that, as well, it was made for a budget of $15 million back in the early 1960s, and it took $70 million at the worldwide box office. However, Steven Spielberg, being a big fan of the film, has looked into it, and he estimates that if it was to be made today, as of 2020, it would cost around about $285 million, which we are talking, that is high-end Hollywood production for today. That would blow majority of the blockbusters out of the water. Interesting fact as well is that Peter O'Toole, who was cast as Lawrence, was actually second choice to play the role. First choice from David Lean, who was the director. First choice to play the role of Lawrence was actually Albert Finney, and there are screen tests of him in Arab clothing, dressed as T.E. Lawrence. And this is my favourite fact, that is the most requested piece of film archive in the British National Film Archives as well. So if you go down to London, that is the most requested piece of footage that you can see Albert Finney in what could have been. Now, of course, the film's fantastic. Peter O'Toole is magnificent in that role. I can't imagine anyone else, but it's still very interesting to see what Albert Finney's interpretation would have been. But anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Stay tuned, videos weekly, more locations incoming, and other pieces of film trivia. So, keep it real, stay safe, enjoy. Thanks for watching.
If you enjoyed this video, then please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more film content. And if you would like to join us for a film location walking tour of Liverpool, you can do so by booking online at realtours.co.uk.